It really is a kind of a science fiction construction of masts and wires at the transmitting and so on. They were ready to send the message from Cornwall in England when there was a natural disaster in Cape Cod, and the station was blown down to the ground. And he decided he didn't want to wait. He didn't want to rebuild it. And strategically, he thought, what if I tried to send the signal? What if I tried to reduce the distance across the Atlantic? I mean, this is the way Marconi thought. And of course, so he said to himself, what is the closest landfall on the North American side? Well, and of course, it was Newfoundland. I mean, Newfoundland was actually about 1,000 kilometers closer to England than Cape Cod. So he sailed for Newfoundland, and being Marconi, everywhere he went, he was constantly, I mean, anytime he got on a ship, there were reporters asking, where are you going? Why are you going there? What are you doing? And he wanted to keep this secret, what he was trying to do. So he came up with a story that he was going to Newfoundland, he was going to try to see if he could receive messages from ships at sea as they passed by on their way to New York. That was the ostensible reason. But actually, what he did, when he arrived in Newfoundland in December, the blustery week, not having the time or the means to actually build a permanent receiving station, he rigged up a system of kites that had been used by the British. Yeah, this is the system. That's Marconi right there. This is actually a reenactment because the original event, it was done in secrecy. He had one assistant, and that was it. There were no witnesses to the original event. By 1901, Marconi's technology was in use in various situations, and among other things, it had been used by the British in the Anglo-Boer War in South Africa, where the British Army was interested in field communication. They had to set up temporary installations, and there was a British Army major by the name of Baden-Powell, a brother of the founder of the Boy Scouts, who developed this system of kites. So basically, they would raise a wire on a kite, and that would be sufficient to receive a signal that could then be translated into by a Morse code tapper into telegraph messages. So he said, why don't we use that? And so they rigged up this system of kites on Signal Hill, and on the third day they received the letter S, three dots, from Cornwall, England, and they received it several times to the point where Marconi was satisfied that that this was working. So they called in the press. New York Times reported in Newfoundland. I mean, all the major newspapers sent reporters to Newfoundland to witness this reenactment that was done a few days later for the benefit of the press and public officials and so on. And there were headlines all over the world of this tremendous accomplishment. Meanwhile, the government of Newfoundland, the colonial government of Newfoundland, had given an exclusive concession to a private company, the Anglo-American Telegraph Company, for all telegraph communication to and from Newfoundland. And they immediately hit Marconi with an injunction, cease and desist. So what does he do now? Well, he briefly thought of contesting it, very briefly, because Marconi was not, that was another fundamental thing about him. He He was litigious when he felt he had to be, but he certainly didn't want to lose a court case. And this looked like, I mean, it really looked like they had a concession. Well, as it turned out, there was an official of the Canadian Post Office in St. John's at the time, and they were, at Marconi and this man named William Smith were actually having dinner together at the